the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters, and peace of Jesus Christ be with you all. So today's reflection is from Matthew chapter 22 verses 1 to 14. Many are called and few are chosen. What does this actually mean? As we read in the verse 14, we all must have heard this phrase, but what does this actually mean? And what is the difference between being called and being chosen? To understand this phrase, we need to reflect on Matthew 22 verses 1 to 14, the parable, the way Jesus tackled what the kingdom is all about through this parable. So in reality, God calls us and invites. The response may be either a yes or a no. Each one is free to respond to the invitation or ignore it to the lack of interest. The king invited people to attend the wedding of his son. The invitation was given to all the guests, but all of them ignored and refused to come. So the king decided to invite them for the second time. So he sends few of his servants, but they were mistreated and even killed. This made the king so angry. He dispatched his servants and instructed them to invite anyone they would meet on the roadside. There were those who responded, so the feast was full with the guests. But the king saw a man not wearing a wedding garment and ordered that man to be taken out of the feast as he did not fit in the feast. So my dear brothers and sisters, among the characters in the parable, each one of us identifies with one of these personalities. We are always invited by God to join him in a feast. So many were invited, but few really showed up. People were very stubborn. They did not just ignore the invitation, but also refused to attend the feast. They disobeyed the king. Most of us are like these people who ignored the king's invitation to be with him in celebrating life and love. How many times did we receive the call to follow the will of God? Maybe in the church, we were asked to live our lives in the Lord when we received Jesus in the form of Eucharist. Why is it so hard to say yes to do the will of God? Why don't we make ourselves available for others and celebrate God's goodness and kindness instead? In the parable, same way, the king extended the invitation to all, to everybody. But like those in the gospel, many also attended the wedding feast, but were not worthy of the feast. The parable may have been addressed to the chief priest or to the elders or the people during the time of Jesus. But it's also very timely for us today. As we say yes to God, but are totally convinced about surrendering him everything. When we give a yes to the invitation of God, our answers must be firm and total. We should be with the answers what we gave, what we responded to Jesus. So sometimes we refuse to listen to what we had already heard. God's invitation to us always been there for us. Every day. But God invites us today to be with him. He is asking us to know him better through these scriptures that we read and ponder upon. Through the sacrament he gave us, the teaching of the church, and through the graces we receive every moment of our life. The grace of God is received in the people we meet every day in every circumstances of our life. Every occasion of the feast we go for. As for the feast, the king and the guest are there. In the kingdom, God and his people are there, celebrating joyfully the feast. So my dear people, just few questions we need to ask ourselves and ponder upon and reflect upon. Ourselves, have I heard the invitation from the Lord for me? Have I said yes to the Lord's invitation? Am I faithful to the yes that I gave to the Lord? And am I committed to do the will of God? And do I strive to be worthy guest in the feast offered by the Lord?